Welcome to another video on the applications of the law of signs. Hopefully this is large enough for you to read. A group of forest rangers are hiking through Denali National Park towards Mount McKinley, the tallest mountain in North America. From their campsite, they can see Mount McKinley, and the angle of elevation from their campsite to the summit is 21 degrees, as we see here. They know the slope of the mountain forms a 127 degree angle with the ground, and that the vertical height of Mount McKinley is 20,320 feet. So this angle is known to be 127 degrees, and the height of the mountain is known to be 20,320 feet. Here's the question. How far away is their campsite from the base of the mountain? So we want to know this distance here. Secondly, if they hike 2.9 miles in an hour, how long will it take them to get to that base camp? Let's go ahead and see if we can gather some additional information from our sketch. If we take a look at this triangle here, we know these two angles and we know the sum must be 180 degrees. That makes this angle here 32 degrees. Next, this angle and this angle are supplementary. Therefore, this angle here would be 53 degrees. Then in this little small right triangle, we know these two angles must add to 90 or must be complementary. So this angle up here must be 37 degrees. Okay, so what it comes down to is looking at this oblique triangle here. If we can find the length of one of the sides, then we can use the law of sines to determine the length of side D. So let's take a look at this small right triangle right here. We can write a trig equation that states that the sine of 53 degrees must equal 20,320 divided by the hypotenuse here. If we can find this hypotenuse, it'll give us the length of one side in this oblique triangle. So let's go ahead and try to do that. So we'll call this H. So we'll have the sine of 53 degrees must equal the opposite side, or 20,320 divided by the hypotenuse, or H. Let's go ahead and make this into a proportion. Now we'll cross multiply. H times the sine of 53 degrees must equal 20,320. We'll divide by the sine of 53 degrees. This will give us H is approximately equal to this quotient. Go to our calculator. 20,320 divided by sine 53 degrees, which is approximately 25,443 feet. Notice that this side is opposite this 21 degree angle. So now we can use the law of sines in this oblique triangle to find the length of D. So we would have the sine of 21 degrees divided by 25,443 feet must equal the sine of 32 degrees divided by D, which is the distance we're looking for. Let's cross multiply. Now divide by sine 21 degrees. This gives us D on the left. And now let's go back to our calculator to determine this value. And so D is approximately 37,622 feet. Now since they're hiking in miles per hour, let's go ahead and convert this distance into miles. So we could multiply this by 1 mile over 5,280 feet. This will simplify the units feet out, and now we can figure out how many miles this is by dividing by 5,280. So it's approximately 7.1 miles. So this is part A, the distance from their camp to the base of the mountain. The second part asks, if they hike 2.9 miles in 1 hour, how long will it take them to get to that base? Let's go to the next screen and answer that question. We know that the distance equals rate times time. So if we solve this equation for t, we would have t equals distance divided by rate. Well, the distance was 7.1 miles, and their rate was 2.9 miles per hour. And this will give us the time in hours. 7.1 divided by 2.9, which is approximately 2.4 hours. And if we wanted to convert this to minutes, 2.4 hours times there's 60 minutes in 1 hour. So the units of hours simplify out, and we're left with 2.4 times 60, which is equal to 144 minutes. So it doesn't specify the units, so in hours it would be 2.4 hours, in minutes it would be 144 minutes. When we are doing problems like this, it's important that we pay attention to the units, because if we didn't, it would lead to the wrong answer. Again, our distances are given in feet, then the rate is given in miles. We have to convert everything into feet or everything into miles to come up with the correct answers. I hope you found this explanation helpful. Have a good day.